want to say again thanks and welcome to all participants. I am Dr. Tim Yu Han. I work in two countries, Myanmar and Malaysia. In Malaysia, I work in International Islamic University, two faculty. One faculty is a dentistry and another faculty is a dental and family medicine department. Today, I want to share with my experience with the audience regarding the epidemiological and clinical relationship between diabetes and periodontal disease. So you may already know, diabetes is a very problem in our medical side. Isn't every clinician already know about how to treat, how to provide the diabetic care, and we are stay ongoing research to provide good quality care to diabetic patients. But we are not familiar with periodontal disease. But they are linked, like I show in the picture, to strains are linking together. First, I will be present epidemiologic care and clinical relationship. So you have already seen this is a diabetes, how to care, how to provide, how to prevent, we already know. So now I want to share a little bit about the periodontal disease. I am not a dentist, but I work in a dentistry for 5 years. So I learned a little bit about the oral head. So in the oral head practice, there's three main diseases for oral practitioner. One is a dental caries. So everybody can have already experienced with the dental caries pain. And then another one is a periodontal disease. This is the inflammation of the gum and infected that they call the periodontium. So another one is the oral cancer. The oral cancer also main problem in oral head. In the oral head practice, then they carry everybody noted, every our patient understand they had to pay, they had to go to dentist. But even in the oral head practice, periodontal disease are overlooked by the patient itself. Because they are not showing too much traversal. Only when we notice the periodontal disease, at the time we already had severe and then we had to lose our teeth. So this is a state of the periodontal diseases I learned from the my dental college. First is gingivitis. After that, my periodontitis. This is terminology. And then moderate and then advanced periodontitis. When you get the advanced periodontitis, you can see here loss of attachment. At the time, you lost teeth automatically without caries. So this is a periodontal diseases. So how they relate to each other? So before going to relationship, I want to show that the problems or magnitudes. You can see this is in Malaysia. Malaysia is a better head indicator and regular survey. That's why we have a trend or the increasing trend of the diabetes. And then this is a Myanmar data. This is a diabetes. We really found out to get that data. We are still going on to collect the prevalence of the diabetes in Myanmar. But you can see in the increasing trend of the diabetes. And then this is a periodontal disease. So this is a oral head. So in the oral head, they are more indicator a little bit different with our medical side. They are thinking there's how much free are the oral head diseases. This is a oral head disease. At that time, we know that periodontal disease, healthy gums are decreasing trend, but suffering or the periodontal disease are increasing trend. So there has a regular survey in Malaysia. That's why we have the exact data increasing trend. For the Myanmar, we have no trend data because we are not regular taking the data in our Myanmar. So we only have the one survey. This is done by the study Myanmar Dental Association, and that we can see and the variation of the periodontal diseases in our country are variation. But most are suffering PD diseases. So caries and periodontal disease, we have said periodontal diseases are suffering in the Myanmar. They are also increasing trend, but we have not too much data for that. So now we will continue to the intervention, and you can see here our medical side fighting the diabetes. And then this is a dental side. They are using the tool to fight the dental diseases, especially PD. This is a periodontal disease. We are familiar with DM. DM is a diabetes. We are not familiar with PD because we are not dentists and we are not we didn't get oral head training in our medical curriculum. So, but They are doing their cholera way, not in the integrated way. So we are overlook the relationship between diabetes and periodontal disease, but we can see clue. This is the last 2 years. We also made a survey in the Malaysia and Myanmar, because when I practice my clinic, then the patient also came to see me to solve the problem, especially toothache and can pay. So that's why I want to know how much problem in our medical clinic regarding the oral health problem. This is a two-country preliminary study. At that time, we noted that here. This is a problem of the study. You can see in here, in Myanmar, this is a green line. So you can see here, more than one disease and associated with other diseases. We noted in our survey, most of the cases came to our clinics for the gigi problem are together with diabetes or other diseases. In Malaysia, and then also PD disease, periodontal disease alone came to see the our medical doctor for their campaign. And then in Malaysia, most are handful of disease, but there's also dentary and PD a problem in Malaysia primary care or the medical practice. So at the time, I have an idea why our country, there's two disease are presented together to the primary care physician, family physician. So that's why we want to know whether this is a relationship or not. So that's why I go back to literature review. So you can see here, in the Harvard University, one study group had already done incident of the diabetes and periodontal diseases. There's a lot of study in the online when we do the search here. So this is a relationship between diabetes and periodontal diseases. This is a US study in the 2013. This study carried out by the two professional Medicare and dentistry. Another one, So this also is a recently published 2012. This is authentic and medical professional together. So we are thinking that, this is a new issue in the our professional in Medicare and dentistry. But you can see 2002 in the Canada, they have already published. And 20th century, this is already published. Periodontal disease is the sixth complication of the diabetes, but all publications around the 20th century are oral health professional in oral health journal, not our medical journal. That's why we overload PD disease relationship with diabetes. So this is an epidemiological relationship. I only take out the one study. At the time, you can see many studies we have, but this is a typical study and a very good study, and then you can see in the study is in 962. This is a reliable sample population, and then this is carried out by the dental professional. That's why first they consider periodontal disease present or absent. So this is a no periodontal diseases, and then this is a periodontal disease present, and then you can see diabetes positive is very high. But the patient, they have no periodontal disease, but they have diabetes, but compared with the PD diseases, they are low rate. And then impaired fasting glucose level also very high in the PD diseases. This is an epidemiological relationship. So PD is a risk factor for diabetes. We have to consider in the publication, they also study and analyze odd ratio. So how much relationship with relationship with PD and diabetes. So my peritonitis, there's a 1.3 time risk to have a diabetes. But moderate and severe, there's a higher 3 to 4 or 2.9. Mesimin is a 5.8, nearly 6 times higher risk for diabetes. So this is an epidemiological relationship. So you can see who are first, we are not considered, we are still studying who can fast, diabetes fast or PD fast? PD fast or diabetes fast? We are still studying. So now this is a clinical relationship. You can see here. This is a typical cases in our Myanmar study. The patient came to see their primary care physician GP for their diabetes. And then we had seen This is an uncontrolled diabetes patient that we can see the severe peritoneal diseases. This is our medical clinics. But in the dental clinics, there's a severe PD disease, difficult to treat. At that time, they test their glucose level. At that time, they see and diagnosis diabetes in the PD clinics. That's why this is a clinical relationship. This is a peritoneal abscess in diabetes patient. This is a typical case in Myanmar. The patient suffering and discharge, and they came to see the physician, medical physician, for the discharge or the mouth, hand. At that time, we test diabetes positive, previously and diagnose diabetes. At that time, we had to refer to the dental surgeon to treat the peritoneal abscess. And then gingivitis, we treat. Medical personnel, how to treat. I also analyze our Myanmar GP practice, how they treat peritoneal disease, only mouthwash and antibiotics. Really thinking that, oh, is it enough for medical practice? But when I working in dentistry, I noticed that this is not enough for peritoneal treatment and gingivitis. We had to do scaling or root cleaning to prevent the recurrence of the PD disease. But we are overlooked to refer to the patient to dentistry. So this is a clinical relationship. So the patient who has a two disease together from the different professional, diabetes and peritoneal diseases. So this is a glycemic control. This is also a problem in our, only 20% of the, our patient have a good glycemic control. At that time, we have to find out other factor beyond the routine factor. At that time, we find out diabetes and PD relationship. So this is a relationship between diabetes and PD. So time limitation, we will a little bit rush. This is the effect of PD on diabetes. So diabetes is a considered, this is a risk factor. Also, this is a negative way. Positive way, if you treat diabetes, we will have a good glycemic control. So peritoneal therapy also affect on decrease the insulin resistance. This is for effect of PD on diabetes. This is the effect of diabetes on PD. Diabetes is a, we already know this is a mother of all diseases, including PD diseases. So this is a, if you have a diabetes, there is a gan swelling and then they also inflammation of the gan support to get more PD. So this is a mechanism of the diabetes and PD relationship. This is a autonomous and then Mendelian. So you can see here, this is a IO chemical relationship mediator and then insulin interleukin 2. This is a changes in the gan overhead. That's why diabetes and PD are vice versa. We call the bidirectional relationship. But as a medical person and public health specialist, we also consider what is a common risk factor. Common ground. You can see common ground in here. Obesity, and then here, unhealthy diet, smoking, and elevated blood glucose level, and the hypertension also common risk factor for diabetes and PD. So this is what we call the bidirectional relationship. Based on that, what should we do? So at the time, we can screen in diabetes in the PD clinics and then PD in the diabetes clinics. This is what we call the coronary care for patient with DMPD. So they will be present in the next speaker. So who will be, how to implement and what is it? So this is a conduct referral. Patient screening in the diabetes and PD patient PD clinics referred to Medicaid. So we have the PD cases we refer to dental clinic to get the proper treatment and the early referral to the patient. So who are beneficiary? Or not only the patient, but also our clinician also get the benefit, and then we get a save money, not only by pocket money, but also government money. Because in Malaysia, all diabetes patients are supported by the governments. That's why we can say the government money in Malaysia. In Myanmar, we use the out-of-pocket money so the patient can save the money by themselves. Also, our practitioner, we also has a benefit because of, we have a good glycemic control of the diabetes patient. We are happy and that our patient rely on the family physician. Oh, our family physician are good, understand the overhead. And they check in the overhead and then refer to dentist timely. So this is a role of family physician in overhead. We can do early recognition of the PD among the diabetes patient. We can promote awareness of the diabetes and PD relationship, and then timely referral to the health professional for further PD treatment. And then we also visit oral examination. This is important for both professional oral cancer. And then we can also counseling for the common risk factor for both diabetes and PD. So finally, we can say achievement by win-win theory. So thank you.